Hey, what's up, guys? I just wanted to make a quick video, and I wanted to give you guys an update on just kind of what I've been up to. This the end of the year, you know, we have the holiday and family time and stuff like that. So I haven't really had much time to post, but you know, I've been working on my garage space, and I want to show you guys my table that I had made for my workshop. This is my garage, and previously all I've had to work with was my Husky 72-inch tool box. Got this from Home Depot, and this is, you guys have seen me work off of this table, and I basically had nothing else. This is just a big open space, but I fired up Fusion 360 and I designed my own work table that was going to fit with my filaments. So I specifically made this so that I can fit 50 boxes of Hatchbox filament on this side and another 50 on the other side. So that's 100 boxes total. And what that did is that freed up some rack space down here, which I'm gonna bring some printers that I have upstairs. I have 17 Ender 3v2s. And so I have 12 in my garage, and I'm gonna put the other 5 down here. And I also bought this, the Ender 6. Sorry for the lighting, it's super bad. I'm gonna put recessed lighting up on the ceiling, but for now, sorry for the grainy video. But anyways, I bought an Ender 6 and I installed Clipper on it because the way I calculate how much I'm going to make by selling my products is how fast I print them. And I've seen videos where the Ender 6, because it's a Core XY 3D printer, I've seen these print 200 millimeters per second. Or, you know, give or take. I know there's arguments to that, but it prints probably 3 times as fast as the Ender 3. So if one Ender 6 can do the work of 2 Ender 3s, I may just start phasing out these Ender 3s and just go with the Ender 6. So that's for another video. I still haven't done any testing yet. Clipper's very new to me, but yeah, I'm gonna be working towards that. Anyways, here's the bench. It's 4 foot by 8 foot. And I have some storage here for my tools. These are little spare parts for the 3D printer, like nozzles, couplers, extruder gears, silicone socks. What else I got here? Just basic 3D printing stuff. Spare screws, some BL Touch probes, and then this is where I keep my boxes for storage, which I'm running super low. Need to go refill that. I'm gonna make this available on probably Thingiverse. I don't know where I would share this, but I just the design file. I got this made by a local carpenter in Houston, Texas, named his company is Just Ask Mo Woodworking, and he did it for a great price. This is all 3/4-inch birch plywood, and this is poly coated. I'm probably gonna put a plexiglass cover just for extra strength. And these, I specifically asked him to not make handles because I have designed my own handles. I tried to do a little Star Wars font, but I don't really like the way it came out. The font, that is. But I have some heat set inserts that I'm going to press into here. I might make some more adjustments to this handle, but basically, I'll probably pick a different color too. Maybe black, I don't know. But yeah, I'm pretty excited about that. Anyways, this is just kind of a very random video. I will get to back to making educational content or content that I feel like is worth creating. Like I said, I'm not just going to spit out stuff just to create content. Actually, I had a viewer leave a comment and he said, thank you for all your videos. They're very different. They're not the rinse and repeat cookie cutter, you know, stuff. So I want to just make something of value for you guys. And I have some things that have come up in my 3D printing farm that I've made note of. I just haven't had time to really put together the video. So yeah, anyways, just wanted to do a quick update for the beginning of the year. And also, if you made it this far, I just want to say thank you so much for subscribing, because I'm at 1500 subscribers, which is pretty crazy. You know, in like 3 months, I think. So, and I actually got YouTube partnerships, which, you know, they're giving me like $3 a day for my views, which is, you know, it's good coffee money. But anyways, yeah, stay tuned. For this year, I'm going to try to put out a video at the very least, I'm going to do once a month. But my goal is once every 2 weeks. But like I said, I'm going to put stuff out that I think is helpful for you guys. That's going to help you make money with your 3D printing farm, because that's the goal of this channel. I want to show you what I'm doing so that you can do it too and make some money. So yeah, that's all I have for you guys. All right, Happy New Year's, and thank you again for subscribing and watching. I love you guys.